हे मेरे परमात्मा, मैं साक्षी देता हूँ। हे मेरे परमात्मा, मैं साक्षी देता हूँ कि तुझे पहचानने और तेरी ही पूजा के लिए तूने मुझे उत्पन्न किया है। तूने मुझे उत्पन्न किया है, हे मेरे परमात्मा, मैं साक्षी देता हूँ कि तुझे पहचानने पर तेरी ही पूजा के लिए तूने मुझे उत्पन्न किया है। तूने मुझे उत्पन्न किया।
The prayer says, I bear witness, O my God, that Thou hast created me to know Thee and to worship Thee. God has created us, each one of us, for two things, to know Him and to worship Him. What do we mean by knowing Him? Because we cannot see Him. We cannot meet Him. We cannot talk to Him. We cannot touch Him. He is not seen anywhere. So how do we know Him? Knowing God means knowing the teachings of God. These are the teachings of God. Here is the kingdom of God. And from this kingdom, all the holy books have come. Through various manifestations of God, through Krishna, through Buddha, through Christ, through Muhammad, through Nanak, through Bahá'u'lláh, and others also. All these manifestations of God have been given these holy books. These holy books have been revealed by God to these people for the whole of humanity. So knowing these teachings, knowing these teachings means knowing God. And worshipping God means obeying these teachings. What are the teachings? For example, 5,000 years ago, the message of justice came to the heart and soul of Krishna. Nyayat apne bandhu ko bhi dand dena dharma hai. For the sake of justice, even if you have to punish your brother, your family member, punish him. But justice must be upheld. So the teaching of justice came through Krishna 5,000 years ago. 2,500 years ago, another message came in the form of Tripitaka, and that was given to Buddha. And that Buddha taught equality. We are all equal in the sight of God. God has created us all equal. Nobody is upper caste, nobody is lower caste, nobody is middle caste. All are equal in the sight of God. So this was the equality. Then 2,000 years ago, another message appeared in the form of Bible, and which was given to Jesus, and He taught us compassion. The kingdom of earth will belong to those who are kind and compassionate. So the teaching of kindness and compassion was given by God through Jesus. And the teaching of equality. Khuda is Rabbul Alameen. He is the Rabb of the whole world. He is the creator of the entire humanity. It is one Allah, one God who has created the whole of humanity. All are children of one God. So this was the message of Muhammad, and who taught us the equality, we are brotherhood. We are all children of one God. We are like brothers and sisters. So the teaching of brotherhood came through Muhammad 1400 years ago. 550 years ago, another message appeared in the form of Guru Granth Sahib, which was given to Guru Nanak Dev Ji, that taught us true sacrifice, Sacha Sauda. true sacrifice, we should sacrifice for each other. And he said, Abbal Allah Noor Upaya, Kudrat ke sab bande, aur ek noor te sab jag upja, kaun bhale kaun mande. We have been all born from one God. We are all children of one God. The same thing which all the manifestations of God have said. So Nanak also said, but he taught us the lesson of true sacrifice. And then 200 years ago, another message came in the form of Kitab-e-Aqdas, which was given to Baha'u'llah. His picture is not available, so we have put the picture of his son, who was the interpreter of his teachings, that is of Abdul Baha, which taught us unity of heart. So these are the teachings. Knowing God means knowing these teachings. And worshipping God means obeying these teachings. These teachings have come from one God. 5,000 years ago, this Bhagavad Gita came to the heart of Krishna. 2,500 years ago, the Buddha got this book, Tripitaka. 2,000 years ago, Jesus got this book through a dove, a worldly god, and that is a symbolic word. That means the enlightenment came to Jesus 2,000 years ago. And 1,400 years ago, Muhammad got the message to a farishta, to an angel, and we kept on coming for 23 years and bringing the teachings of God and giving to Muhammad that were written on palm leaves and backbones of the sheep, and they were collected and that became the Holy Quran. The Holy Quran is not written by Muhammad, it has come from Allah, it has come from God. And so is Bible. Bible is not written by Jesus, it has come from God. It was revealed to Jesus. So is Buddha. He was sitting beneath the tree for many, many years in search of ultimate knowledge, and he got the enlightenment. So from there, and this also is a book not written by Krishna. It has been revealed to God, revealed by God to Krishna, and which was mentioned here. So all these books have been revealed. Guru Granth Sahib is also not written by Nanak. It was revealed. The teachings of Guru Granth Sahib were revealed to Nanak by God. So is the Kitab-e-Aqdas. It was revealed to God, revealed to Abdul Baha, revealed to Baha'u'llah. So dear children, all the holy books are revealed books. The teachings of God are mentioned in these books. Knowing these teachings is the knowing God. Obeying these teachings is the worship of God. Rest of it is rituals. We do rituals and we consider ourselves, we are doing the worship. Worship is not that ritual. Ritual is not the worship. But ritual, worship means know the teachings of God, reflect on the teachings of God. 1 hour's reflection is preferable to 70 years of pious worship. So 1 hour's reflection is preferable to 70 years of pious worship. If we read these holy books for 70 years, cram it up, mug it up, and repeat it thousands and thousands of times, millions and millions of times, or billions and billions of times, it is of no use. Read one quotation from Bible, or Holy Quran, or Guru Granth Sahib, or Tripitaka, or Kitab-e-Aqdas, or Bhagavad Gita, and reflect on it. 1 hour's reflection is preferable to 70 years of pious worship. We understand the teaching of God, reflect on it, go into the deep of the teaching, and then understand it, and then apply in our lives, act upon it. That is the worship of God. So knowing God means knowing these teachings, number one. Number two, all these teachings have come from one source, because there is source is one. The source is only God, Almighty God. This is the source. This is the, you know, God has no form. We have put some light just to show that God, you know, he doesn't take a body form. He is a soul and he has never taken birth. He has no mother, no father. He has no name. Name we have kept ourselves. Hindi knowing people kept his name as Bhagwan, Ishwar, Paramatma. Urdu knowing people kept his name as Allah. Arabi people, Arabi knowing people kept his name as Rab or Rabbul Alameen. English knowing people kept his name as God. In all the languages like German, French, Russian, Spanish, in all the languages of the world, there is a name given by the people knowing that language. So God has known him. It is we who realize that there is some power beyond us, and that power we should remember him and we should pray him. So for the facilitation of prayer, we have kept a name. He has no name. So dear children, he is only one. He has sent all the manifestations of God. In Ramayana it is written, Jav jav hoya dharma ki hani, baadhai asura adhama abhimani, tav tav prabhu dhari vivida sharira harai kripanidhi sajjana pira. That means whenever there is a decay in the righteousness, then the manifestation of God will come again and again. So God will send his manifestations, his divine representatives again and again. But there is only one God. So one God has sent all these manifestations of God. All these manifestations of God have come from one source. All the books have come from one source. All these books have come from one source for all the people of the world. They are from God. And God will never send anything for a particular kind of people. God doesn't send anything for particular people. God sent everything for all the people. And if it is from God, it is for the whole of the humanity. And if, unfortunately, out of ignorance, Hindu thinks that Gita is for them, Buddhist think that Tripitaka is for them, Christians feel that Bible is for them, Muslims feel that Quran is for them, and Sikh feels that Guru Granth Sahib is their book, and Baha'i feel that this is the Kitab Ekdas for them. But this is utterly ignorance. It is ignorance. These are the books sent by God. And God, if they are from God, they are for the whole of humanity. And if they are not from God, it is not, the Quran is not from a Muslim leader. Had it been, if it is for only Muslims, then it cannot be from God. God cannot be from Muslim God. God is not a Hindu God. Not a God is not a Christian God or a Buddhist God. God is God, Almighty. He is the creator of the whole of universe. He is the creator of the entire humanity. He is the only one who has created us all. All the manifestations of God have been created by him. Krishna, Buddha, Muhammad, Nanak, Jesus, they are all creations of one God. They took birth, they had a mother or father, and they died. And they died, and their soul ascended to the same God. And their bodies remained here. Like our bodies, when we die, our bodies remain here. Soul ascends to God. Everybody's soul ascends to one God. So is the soul of all the manifestations of God ascended to one God. So there is only one God. Why people are fighting in the name of religion? So much of agony, so much of hatred, so much of killings, murders, so much of difference that I am a Hindu, I am a Muslim, I am a Christian, I am a Buddhist. This is all ignorance. Here you see, so many people sitting here, they prove to be how different they are from each other. Through their different beard, through their different caps, different turbans, and all kind of differences, they want to prove that how different we are. But it is all ignorance. God is one. Religion is one. Man is one. God has never changed. God is for the whole of humanity. There is only one God for all of us. There are no different gods. God of Muhammad, God of Jesus, God of Nanak is only one. They have only one God. They are not different gods. But why do we feel that our gods are different? This is ignorance. And therefore, what is a school? A school is a light of the society. A school is the lighthouse of society. to provide a meaningful education, a spiritual direction, guidance and leadership to students, their parents, and the society in general. A modern school must try to establish divine civilization on earth in place of a rapidly increasing disunited, inhuman, lawless, unjust, and satanic civilization. If a modern school does not become a lighthouse of society, it will become a dark house of society. 3. If a modern school does not try to establish a divine civilization, it will spread satanic civilization. The school must be restored to its traditional role as a lighthouse of society, and teachers must be restored to their traditional role as the transmitters of morality, builders of character, and custodians of the culture. So, dear friends, what is a school? A school is a lighthouse of society. What is the light it has to give? You know, here you see, a school is a house of worship. All the religions are shown there. You can see at the top, a school is a house of worship. And all the religion symbols are there. So a school should not be denominational. Christian school or Muslim school or Shia school or Sunni school or Catholic or Protestant or Hindu school or this kind of Sanatani school or Arya Samaji school or Nirankari school or Akali school. This kind of division is out of ignorance. The division must go. We have to change the world. The school must be restored to its traditional role as a lighthouse of society, and teachers must be restored to their traditional role as a transmitters of morality, builders of character, and custodians of the culture.
Montessori School Films and Radio Division is organizing the 9th International Children's Film Festival, CMS-ICFF, from the 5th to the 13th of April 2017, an effort towards promoting the Indian philosophy of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, one people, one world, a crucial step towards child welfare through the medium of cinema.
हम अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर आगे बढ़ना चाहते हैं, ये हमारी एक प्रवृत्ति में है। लेकिन अंतर्राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर बढ़ने के लिए हमें उनकी अच्छी चीज़ों को सीखना है और अपनी अच्छी चीज़ों को बनाए रखना है। तो मैं आप सबसे यही कहूँगा कि गांधी जी ने जो ये आयोजन करा है, ये सफल हो, लोग मनोभाव के साथ में यहाँ के अंतर्राष्ट्रीय फिल्म महोत्सव का आनंद उठाएँ। आपको मेरी शुभकामनाएँ। आपने मुझे बुलाया, मैं बहुत बहुत आभारी हूँ। धन्यवाद।
Chairman CFSI Mr. Mukesh Khanna unveiled the festival logo, festival poster, and declared the festival.
Mr. Mukesh Khanna and founder manager of.
You do. I hereby declare the 9th International Children's Film Festival 2017 open.
Another round.
All the best to everybody, all the best to children. बच्चों फिल्में देखो बैठकर ये फिल्में आप लोगों के लिए आई हुई हैं इसलिए फिल्मों को देखिए एंजॉय कीजिए सीखिए उनसे आप और शक्तिमान बनिए हर बच्चा शक्तिमान बनना चाहिए.
The festival brochure was also launched. This book is a compilation of some 600 movies made in the year 2016, previewed and selected from over 1500 movies received from 102 countries.
These are completely clean and meaningful and entertaining movies, which is there, the collection is there, along with the synopsis in this book.
Mr. Mukesh Khanna energized the young audience when he delivered his famous lines from the children's television series, Shaktiman.
Har bachcha bada hokar shaktiman banna chahiye, kyunki desh mein shaktimanon ki aavashyakta hai. और मैं उत्तर प्रदेश को बधाई देना चाहूँगा कि उनके स्टेट में हमारे देश का असली शक्तिमान योगी आदित्यनाथ जी आए हैं जो रियल मायने में शक्तिमान है. मैं फिर वही CMS स्कूल है, फिर वही लखनऊ है, फिर वही आप सब बच्चे हैं, फिर मैं आप लोगों के सामने हूँ और फिर हमारे वही योद्धा श्री जगदीश गांधी जी हैं जिन्होंने हमेशा अपने सर पर ये बीड़ा उठाया है कि हर साल यहाँ पर बच्चों को लाया जाए और उनको देश की और विदेश की चिल्ड्रन फिल्में दिखाई जाएं. मैं चाहता हूँ देश का बच्चा बच्चों के लिए बनाई गई स्पेशली फिल्म दे शुड वॉच. यू आर एट द फेज ऑफ योर लाइफ वेयर द होल लाइफ of yours is going to stand on your shoulders. Make your shoulders strong. Watch the films which are presented here because they are meant to be given you direction in how you live, how you think, how best. Shaktiman also used to say, always used to say, first month, sit tallest, stand tallest and walk tallest. Aise mantra aap padhiye aur rakhiye and enjoy kijiye. I am here for you only. Always for you. And Jagdish Gandhi ji always calls me. I was in London this time. I thought I won't be able to make it, but unka agrah itna strong hota hai ki main unko mana nahi kar sakta, and I came back from London and I am here with you everybody. So bachchon ko shaktiman ki taraf se dher sari shaktiyan, aur agar bachchon ke liye kuch kehna chahu to yahi kahunga ki
Pankhri Gidwani, the reigning crown FBB Femina Miss India 2016, a final year student of Lamartnir Girls College, Lucknow, shared her journey to stardom and said, failures are acceptable, but aiming low is criminal.
It's really cumbersome after some time. And this is a very good way to make the children learn the perspectives of life, widen their horizons, and make them think about new creative things that they can bank upon and they can build up in their lives. And मुझे लगता है कि films एक ऐसा जरिया है जिसमें आप जो अपनी society में देखते हो, जो अपने आसपास देखते हो, वो एक visualization में देखते हो. And उसको एक बार recollect करने से आपके मन में उसकी memory बनती है. And that is how I think a community builds up. That is how people remember what is happening around them and want to work towards a cause or not. So this is a very, very innovative way to make the children learn a lot. And congratulations to CMS for that. And apart from that, मैं सबसे ये कहना चाहूँगी कि मेरी ये जो journey रही है बहुत ही dynamic रही है. मतलब इट्स बीन अ लॉट ऑफ चांसेस दैट आई हैव टेकन एंड तभी मैं यहाँ पहुँच पाई हूँ. सो मैं सबसे यही कहना चाहूँगी कि लाइफ में जो भी अपॉर्चुनिटी आए, ग्रैब इट एंड गो फॉर योर ड्रीम्स एंड जस्ट चेज देम डाउन द लाइन, बिकॉज यू नेवर नो व्हेन यू विल गेट द अपॉर्चुनिटी अगेन. सो अपनी पैशंस को, अपने ड्रीम्स को ज़रूर फॉलो करो एंड ऑलवेज टेल योर पेरेंट्स टू सपोर्ट यू थ्रू इट, बिकॉज मुझे अपने पेरेंट्स का बहुत सपोर्ट मिला एंड दैट इज़ वाई आई एम हेयर. इट्स अ लॉट ऑफ क्रेडिट टू देम. सो ऑलवेज चेज योर ड्रीम्स एंड नो दैट यू आर वेरी यूनिक एंड दैट यू कैन मेक अ डिफरेंस इन द सोसाइटी. थैंक यू.
Amay Pandya, who made his debut on the big screen with the film Viva, followed by his role in a 2010 3D animation film, Toonpur Ka Superhero, has been associated with CMS International Children's Film Festival since 2012, said,
"So, it feels great to be with you, sir. And Ritwik is again my childhood friend. So, uske saath bhi yahan pe hoon. Wo bhi acha lag raha hai. आप सबके साथ बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है यहाँ पे आके एंड आई जस्ट वांट यू गाइस टू एंजॉय द फिल्म फेस्टिवल एंड थैंक यू सीएमएस फॉर गेटिंग मी ग्रेट फ्रेंड्स लाइक पंखुरी एंड सुहानी. सो या दैट्स इट. थैंक यू गाइस.
12-year-old सुहानी भटनागर, who essayed the role of young Babita in the 2016 release movie Dangal, based on the real-life story of Indian women wrestlers, the Fogart sisters, was happy to be a part of this festival.
Want to thank everybody for calling me here, and I had a great time, and I also made great friends like Pankhuri Didi and Amay. So, and also had a chance to meet Mukesh and Mukesh sir, and Ritvik is also here, my so whom I've worked with. So it was a great experience, and I enjoyed a lot here. And I want to thank everybody for such a warm welcome. And so thank you so much.
Ritvik Sahor, who played the role of Parsi boy Kayo in the 2012 movie Ferrari Ki Sawari, also young Omkar in the 2016 release movie Dangal, was happy that his movie Gauru was chosen as the inaugural film for the his film Gauru, made by CFSI, was chosen to be shown at this film festival. Director of the movie One Moment, which was screened at the festival, was honored by the festival director, Mr. V. Kurian. CFSI movie Gauru, about a story about a 13-year-old shepherd boy, Gauru, whose grandmother is on deathbed, has never been to her native village after marriage. It's her last wish to visit her native place.
Shikshatmak Sanskritik Karikram Evam Chintan Hetu विश्व एकता सत्संग में आप सभी सपरिवार सादर आमंत्रित हैं.